Check, check. Hey, how we doing? Thanks for being here, guys. So nice to have you here tonight, joining us for the San Juan College Symphonic Band Spring Term Concert. I'm Tom Fetz. I am a music professor here at San Juan College and your conductor. And please welcome. Welcome to being here. Thank you for coming. We've got, I think, a pretty exciting program for you tonight. A lot of diversity, a lot of interesting pieces, a lot of fun music. I want to thank several people. First, the stage crew, Lane Easley's crew, and Forrest Taubel specifically, and Ed Halsenbach and Stephen Mirabel, who are audio engineers and recording engineers, and they've worked out a great kind of electroacoustic piece that we're going to do on the second half that I think you're going to be excited about. It's going to be great, so we want to thank them especially. Also, administrators, President Pendergrass, Dr. Ake, Dean Nass, and Don Ellis for all their support. First tune was obviously the classic I've Got Rhythm by the great American composer George Gershwin. That version was actually arranged by Ken Dye, who was the marching band director at Notre Dame University. And there have been many fine arrangements, of course, of this Gershwin classic. However, that particular selection, of course, is entertaining for the band with the clapping and chanting and also showcasing the percussion section. Next is another Warhorse Symphonic Band piece by the classic band composer Percy Grainger, called Irish Tune from County Derry. Grainger was an American pianist and composer who was born actually in Australia. This tune is also known as Londonderry Air, that originated from County Londonderry in Ireland, which is now Northern Ireland. And it's popular among the Irish diaspora and is basically very well known throughout the world. The tune has been played, and is played still, as the victory anthem of Northern Ireland at the Commonwealth Games, and obviously the song Danny Boy, which you'll recognize, uses the same tune. So it's a lovely setting of this folk tune, and this is going to be Irish Tune from County Derry. Thank you. one more person, or multiple people probably, and sure, thank and remind myself to thank, is the Mike McCarthy's crew that does all the video and audio for us. And I put on the back of the program, if you go to the San Juan College music department, but specifically also the, I think it's called Bands, Orchestra, and Combos Facebook page, you will see the concert in its entirety on video. And Mike's crew does a great job. So check that out, like us, please, and make sure that you stay tuned to that on a weekly basis for announcements and concert footage and other exciting things. Next is the Imperial Guards March by Robert Brown Hall. Robert Brown Hall, usually just known as actually R.B. Hall in a lot of his compositions, was a leading composer of marches and other music for brass bands specifically. Really a principal American composer of marching music. He was born in Maine, apparently seldom left his native state during his lifetime. He died in Portland, Maine. His music, though, has traveled around the world, and he's particularly popular in the United Kingdom, so much so that many lovers of brass band music there kind of mistakenly imagine him that Mr. Hall was an English composer as opposed to an American composer. His celebrated march, Death or Glory, written in 1895 and dedicated to the 10th Regiment Band in Albany, New York, is a well-known staple of his brass band concerts and competitions all over the UK. So Mr. Hall was famous during his lifetime and was a particularly fine player on cornet or trumpet, and served as for a time as the conductor of the Bangor Main Band, as a soloist conductor, composer, teacher, and still remembered in Maine. In fact, the last Saturday in June every year, they have what's called the officially Robert Brown Hall Day in the state of Maine. So it'd be pretty cool to have a day in your state named after you. So Mr. Hall has written Imperial Guards March. Thank you. Right, next piece is called In Shining of the Stars by Robert Sheldon, another American composer. This is a slow piece. It's designed really to produce a mood of kind of uplifting, feel good, happy harmonies, should be enjoyable. It's composed in 1996. It, again, utilizes kind of lush harmonies, counter lines that allow for musical development and phrasing and nuance that the band does really well. Mr. Sheldon taught instrumental music both in Florida and the Illinois public school system, and has also served on the faculty at Florida State University, where he taught conducting and instrumental music education classes and also directed the university band. So this is In the Shining of the Stars by Robert Sheldon.
Thank you.
worship piece. That is awesome. It gives me goosebumps every time we play it. They did a great job. And there's several band members that have come up here in the last just week or two to kind of help us out. This was a really unique day for a lot of these guys on stage. Today was actually the high school state band festival in Albuquerque. And about half of the people on the stage played in that festival and then busted back up here to be here tonight. All the people from Kirtland High School. The Kirtland High School band members, stand up, please. So they're doing double duty today, and we're really proud of them. First of all, for making it to state, which is awesome, but also for being here and playing with us, because they mean a lot to us. And last night's rehearsal was a bit thin. We didn't have them here, so it's great to see everybody. And also, I want to especially recognize their director, Miss Deanna Stevens, who is the director of bands at Kirtland High School, playing baritone saxophone. And we're lucky enough to have several music educators in the Farmington area and in the San Juan County School District to play with us, aside from Miss Stevens. Miss Tabitha Pelletero, excuse me, who is the elementary music teacher at Animas Elementary School. Please include Tabitha Pelletero. Miss Jennifer Lasley on clarinet, who teaches at two middle schools doing band, Mesa View and Tibbetts Middle Schools. Jennifer Lasley. Miss Jessica Scrutters, who is the director of bands at Kirtland Middle School, playing French horn. Jessica. And Miss Melissa Kimball, who is the director of bands out at Bloomfield at the middle school and high school. Melissa Kimball. Just the middle school. Melissa's done a lot this year. She's been covering different people, and she's helping out, and she's playing with us too, so I'm just so grateful. And all the guys that are here. Mr. Stamets, who's playing tuba, normally plays trombone with us. He's actually, he only had one rehearsal all semester because he's a music minister at a church. So please congratulate or thank Mr. Stamets on tuba. Okay, moving right along, we're gonna close the first half with Jake Locook's challenging piece called Into the Light. Into the Light was commissioned by a New Jersey high school wind ensemble in loving memory of a young woman named Catherine Bell, who was a clarinetist in the band who died in an accident. It was premiered in a special concert in her honor in December of 1995. The work is a celebration and hopefully a feeling of transcendence for her life going into the light. Please don't go anywhere. We hope you come back. The second half is actually better than the first, believe it or not. It's going to be really exciting. You won't want to miss it. So we're going to play Into the Light, take about a 10-minute break, and come back and play more music for you. Thank you for being here.